Welcome students, I am Ramin Singh Chauhan and we will be taking today's topic interference. So what is interference? We will talk about, but before starting interference, that we are studying interference, and interference is part of optics. And what is optics? Optics is the branch of physics which involves the behavior and properties of light. So in this branch of optics, we study behavior and properties and other phenomena related to light. Now in interference, what is interference? That we will take on. In optics, we have two types of branches. One is physical optics or wave optics. Is a branch of optics that studies interference, diffraction, polarization, and the second one is ray optics, which is about study of reflection, refraction, etc. So reflection, refraction are related to particle nature of light, and interference, diffraction, polarization are related to wave nature. So now we will take on the type of interference. So before we start, let us learn about interference. What is interference? What interference actually is? So when we are talking of interference, what we are doing, we are taking two waves which are coherent and traveling in the same direction. And when they are traveling in the same direction, they are getting overlapped. Means if they are not getting overlapped, then interference will not observe. What we need superposition of the waves. So when two coherent waves are traveling in the same direction and they get overlapped, then intensity of the region of overlapping or the region of superposition changes and gets redistributed, and there is a distribution of maxima and minima. This type of redistribution of intensity of light is called interference. And this can be of two types. One is constructive interference, and the second one is destructive interference. So in constructive interference, the amplitude of the resultant wave is greater than that of either individual wave. So when we are talking of constructive interference, means when intensity of one wave is adding to the intensity of other wave in the same phase, then we can say that plus A, that is 2A. Suppose the amplitudes of one wave is plus A and the other wave is plus A. So plus means in the same phase, in the same direction, you can say, if we are making a wave, then when this plus A, we will get plus 2A. So in the same phase, we will get double the intensity, double the amplitude, and when amplitude will be double, the intensity will increase. So we can say in constructive interference, the amplitude of the resultant wave is greater than that of either individual wave. And when we are talking of destructive interference, the amplitude of the resultant wave is less than that of either individual wave. Means when destructive interference is taking place, then one wave is having amplitude A in one direction, that is plus A, and the other wave is having amplitude A in opposite direction, that is minus A. Means the two waves are in opposite phase and they are having the same amplitude but in opposite phase. So when we will add up the amplitude plus A minus A, we will get 0. So in that case, we can say that when destructive interference is taking place, this we talk about this special case when the amplitudes are same, then we are having zero resultant. But when they are not same, we will have some value, but that value will be less than the amplitudes of the either individual wave. So in that case, we will find that the resultant is less than the individual wave. So in this way, the destructive interference takes place, and in destructive interference, the waves are out of phase. Now we will talk about one experiment, which is basic experiment, or you can say the first experiment performed related to interference, that is Young's double slit experiment. And it was performed by Thomas Young, and he demonstrated interference in light waves from two sources in 1801. Here we can see the setup. These are two slits, S1, S2, and this is a screen where we will observe the fringes. So from S1, S2, this is very narrow slit, and the distance or the slit width is very small, S1, S2. So when waves are coming, suppose when wave is coming from infinity, because we are having this plane wave front, it means that wave is coming from infinity and it is passing through this slit S1 and S2. When this plane wave front is passing through S1 and S2, it is splitting, and one wave front is generating from S1 and another is generating from S2. Means we are having two waves which are coherent, because they are formed by splitting of the same wave front, and these two waves from S1 and S2 gets overlapped, and when they are in the same phase, those lines are giving the maxima, and when they are in the opposite phase, means crest of one phase, one wave is falling on the trough of the other wave, then that is they are out of phase, in opposite phase. And then we can see that these black lines, they are showing the black line where the waves are in opposite phase, and these red lines are showing the points on the line which are having the same phase, they are in the same phase. So what we will find, that by joining these points, we will find a fringe on the screen, and since these are points, these points are joined for the same phase points, we will have maxima, and then we will have black line, that is minima, maxima, minima. In this way, we will find from the center to opposite on the either side maxima, minima, and the central maxima is called zero or the zeroth order maxima, and other maxima are called first order, second order, and so on the screen. And similarly, the minima is called first minima, second minima, and so on. This is the Young's double slit experiment. Here we can see that the barrier is from the distance between barrier or double slit S1, S2 to the screen is given by some values. Region mark maxima is A, correspond to a bright fringe in B. So we will see here constructive interference occurs at point O. Here at point O, we know that S1, the wave from S1 is going to the O, and the wave S2 is going to the O. S1, S2 to the O, like they are at perpendicular bisector, the point O is at the perpendicular bisector of S1, S2. It means the length of S1 to O and the length of S2 to O is same, and the when these waves are reaching at point O, they are in the same phase and constructive interference occurs. So in constructive interference occurs at point O, the two waves travel the same distance, therefore they arrive in phase. As a result, constructive interference occurs at this point and a bright fringe is observed at the center. So in this way we can observe the patterns of interference on the screen. Now we will see the geometry. The distance between screen and the double slit is L, and suppose the slit width S1 S2 is equal to D and Q is the midpoint. So from here we can determine the phase difference delta. Here delta is path difference. So the path difference delta is found from geometry. Here we can see the path length of the wave from S1 to P. If we are observing the intensity or nature of the point P, then we will understand first the path difference at point P by the waves of coming from S1 and S2. So the length of the wave from S1 to P is R1, and the length of the wave from S2 to P is R2. And if we draw a perpendicular from S1 to S2 P, because we can see that S1 P is less than S2 P. So from S1, when we are drawing a perpendicular here, we can see this extra distance is delta, and hence we can find out this phase difference. We can use this path length or path difference, and this path difference is equal to R2 minus R1. This is R2 and this is R1. We can see that this is R2 minus R1. So here R2 minus R1, we find delta, that is path difference, and from this triangle S1, S2, and suppose this point is some other point, or we can see this angle is theta, then from this theta angle using this distance D, S1, S2, and delta, we can find out delta. So here we can find out delta is equal to D sine theta. So R2 minus R1 is equal to D sine theta. This assumes the paths are parallel. Not exactly true, but a very good approximation if L is much greater than D. So this gives an approximation that in case when L is much greater than D. Now conditions for interference. To observe interference in light waves, the following two conditions must be met. The sources must be coherent. They must maintain a constant phase with respect to each other. The sources should be monochromatic. Monochromatic means they have a single wavelength. So the sources must be coherent. Conditions for interference. What are the conditions for interference? That the sources must be coherent. Coherent means when the waves, two or more than two waves, are traveling with the constant phase difference with respect to time with each other, then they are said to be coherent. And what is phase? Phase is angle traversed by a wave in a given time. So we can say for interference, the sources must be coherent, and the second condition is the sources must be monochromatic, that is mono plus chromatic, that is they must be having single wavelength of light. Methods to produce coherent sources are division due to amplitude and division due to wavefront. So in division of amplitude, what we are doing, we are dividing the amplitude of wave, and when amplitude is divided, we are getting two waves of different amplitude by the same wave. And since these two waves are divided by a single wave. That's why these two waves are having a constant phase difference with each other, and they are called coherent waves due to division of amplitude. In the same way, if a wave front is divided in two wave fronts, then the two wave fronts will be having a constant phase difference with each other because they are divided from one original wave front, and that's why this type of coherent sources are called coherent sources by division of wave front. So this is all for today. Next topic we will study in next class. Thank you.